Welcome, dear friends. It's no secret that the American government and military agency DARPA invented the internet. Today we'll look at how America benefited from being the first to launch this game-changing technology.
We will compare the game-changing technologies of the USA with the European Union. We will express our opinion on what the EU can do to jointly create a European economic miracle, which we consider to be the real GDP growth of the EU countries at the same rate as the growth of Western countries in the 1970s.
If we look at average universities, we can say that while professors in Europe were getting acquainted with computers, students in the USA were learning to connect the first networks. The US government agency DARPA played a crucial role in the birth of the internet by funding and coordinating the development of key networking technologies and protocols. While it was not a direct manufacturer of commercial hardware, it was involved in the first tender documents, and its investments and initiatives laid the foundation for the emergence of an entire networking hardware industry.
The initiative of the state, which financed and coordinated this research also in the academic and private sectors, was important, thus connecting the intention with the commercial sphere. It is important to note that the government, through the agency DARPA, managed everything to achieve the goal. And the result? They launched a new, completely groundbreaking game-changing technology, the internet.
And what did this result bring to the United States? Roughly 30 years after the invention of the internet, they had 100% of the world's 10 richest companies doing business online.
Today, more than 50 years after the launch of the first APANet network, the USA has 12 representatives in the top 20. The EU has only the Swedish company Spotify among the world's largest internet companies. This is the result when the state helps to launch a new game-changing technology in practice. To add to this, China has 4 companies in the top 20, followed by Canada, Singapore, and Argentina. The US has gained other advantages from the invention of the internet. The 13 DNS root servers are absolutely essential for the functioning of the entire internet. 10 of them are in the US, only 2 are in the EU, and 1 is in Japan. These are not the only advantages that this key technology has brought them.
Although operating systems are purely commercial projects, in combination with the internet, they provide the US government with almost unlimited possibilities in technological access to information. We are scientists, we do not claim and we do not have evidence that this is happening. However, we will list the possibilities of what data operating system manufacturers and probably also US secret services can access. If you are the manufacturer of the operating system, you have access to everything that the user does not protect with other, special software. That is, to all kinds of biometric data, photos, files, including scientific ones. Keystrokes, pages that users have visited, and other data from computers, mobile phones, and other devices. At the same time, the efficiency of information processing and use is now increased by artificial intelligence.
We want to show that the vision and active role of states in achieving the goal is irreplaceable for a modern economy. The current EU system is completely different and unfortunately not successful.
The EU always lags behind the US and China in implementing game-changing technologies. We have caught up in navigation, internet, and AI chat. It cannot compete in semiconductors. Starlink is also better than EU satellites. We are also behind in humanoids or military technologies. Let's compare the differences between the US and the EU in approach. Why is the USA more successful? DARPA uses the top-down model. It knows from the beginning what it wants to achieve. It determines the direction and goal of the research itself, based on its experience and suggestions from scientists. It manages projects directivity, but is very flexible to change anything during the research. The commercial research team is an equal partner for it. For DARPA, the most important thing is to achieve a goal that can be used in practice as quickly as possible.
The EU uses the bottom-up model, where the EU only gradually becomes familiar with the project's issues at the beginning and during the research. The applicant is not a partner with whom the European Commission achieves scientific goals. The most important thing is to check the achievement of milestones and timely reporting. Achieving the goal is important in order to justify the funds provided. If the set goal is not achieved, the applicant returns the grant. From the EU's perspective, nothing happens. In the end, the European Innovation Council is mainly a distributor of grants.
5 years ago, together with 11 universities, we applied to the European Commission for a subsidy for the CzechWay project. It was the only and so far the last opportunity for a private company to apply for 100% cost coverage, i.e. without co-financing. We are a small think tank, a small scientific team, and it is not even theoretically possible for a company of our size to make money from co-financing the development of a new mode of transport. See with this what the application looks like in the EU, in practice.
There are strict rules for submitting an application. The applicant must justify the entire project on 15 A4 pages. No more is allowed. Explanations are not free, but have given rules. Any contact with the evaluator is excluded. We were not allowed an oral hearing, even though we requested one.
The EU gave us a brief answer that it would not finance the CzechWay project. Maybe because we failed and did not sufficiently explain the benefits of the new mode of transport, maybe the evaluators failed. Why should we want another mode of transport?
Of all the expenses that the railways in the Czech Republic pay for railway transport routes, they earn only 6% themselves and cover the rest from subsidies. The real cost of a railway ticket is higher than a plane ticket, but the public does not know this.
We can't all fit on the road anymore, and driving a car on crowded roads is not pleasant. Moving part of the transport performance to the railway is not financially profitable. Let's solve the problems of transport and the economies of EU countries as one project. Let's calculate the financial benefits of the profitable CzechWay transport concept. If we are right and we still believe that the CzechWay concept is profitable, then because the European Innovation Council did not pay enough attention to the evaluation of the CzechWay project, we lost 5 years of development of a completely new game-changing technology. Only a feasibility study can calculate how many tens of billions each EU country has lost annually due to this delay and continues to lose.
What can the European Innovation Council do to create a European economic miracle?
The system of 15 A4 pages and three evaluators of breakthrough projects is failing and causing significant damage to the European Union. Let's take a look at the DARPA system and change the approach to assessing and managing these types of projects.
Game-changing technologies are so valuable to the EU that, in our opinion, the EU should hold oral negotiations on each of them for several months, so that the evaluators do not miss a single detail.
European Innovation Council, distributing grants is not enough. Explaining some issues is so complex that it is only possible to penetrate them through joint research. Form a team with commercial scientists and universities and develop key technologies together. The next part will be particularly interesting. We will discuss, in our opinion, the second biggest cause of the decline in real growth in the economies of EU countries. We will declassify the second, globally new game-changing technology, point number 5, of the CzechWay program. Together, with the help of science, we will create a European economic miracle. We will start the growth of living standards. Together, we will do it. Thank you for your support.